Welcome to MooMooMath. In this video, I'd like to talk about inequalities and then look at a couple examples. Before we get started, let's review with a couple of the symbols. This first symbol here is equal to greater than. And say, for instance, you can have 5 is greater than 4. The way I remember it is that this end is larger than the other end, so 5 is greater than 4. This next example is less than. And it is 3 is less than 5. Again, the endpoint is there. Now, if you were to graph these, this is called an open. And what you do is you draw a circle around it. And I'll show a couple examples. And that means that it is not included. And so for less than, again, you graph it with an open symbol. And it is a circle. Now, this next one is greater than and equal. So it could be 5 is greater than or equal than 1. And it is drawn on the number line with a closed circle. This next one is less than. And this is not equal to. So let's go back again. This one is greater, less, greater than, equal, greater and equal. This is less and equal. This next one is not equal. And then sometimes you get on a number line an example like this. And whenever you have two going in opposite directions, you use or. So in this particular example, since it is an open, it would be less than or greater than. And then when you have an example like this, you use and. Okay, so now let's look at a couple examples. And we'll look at some graphs and write them, and then we will look at some inequalities and graph them. So let's first jump to this first example here. I had my paper in the wrong order, sorry. And how would you go ahead and write this first number line? Well, it is open, which means that it is greater than, so it would be x is greater than 6, okay? This next one, it is closed, meaning that it is less than and equal to, so x is less than and equal to 4. And notice that the x, the end, is smaller than the 4. Okay. This next example is open, so it would be x is less than 4. Okay. Now this next one, remember, it is an in-between, meaning you use the and, so it's going to be x is greater than 4, and notice, remember, it's open, so it's greater than, and x is less than 8. Okay, now let's move to the next example, and it uses the word or. So it's going to be x is less than or equal to 3 or greater than 8. Sorry, I got distracted there. Okay, next let's move down to two more examples. This one would be, since it's open, it would be x is less than 4. This one, remember, it's in between, so it would be an and, okay? So it would be closed, so it would be x is greater than equal to 3 and x is less than 7. And finally, what do we do with an example like this, okay? We've got this example. Well, this is one you may not have seen before, but this is x is not equal to 5. So that means it can be every other number except 5. Okay? Now, let's move on to another way to do this. And I have the inequality, and we're going to graph it on the number line. So x is greater than 4. Well, we know we're at 4. Do we do open or close? We do open because it does not include 4. It's greater than 4, so it will be drawn like this. How about x is greater than or equal to 4, so that's going to be a closed, and it is less than 8. that will be open, and it will be drawn like this. Next, x is less than 3, so it's open, and it's greater than or equal to 7. Okay, and finally, how about this one? Any number except 7. May not even encounter that. You just draw a circle around or keep it open, and then it goes like this. Okay, I hope that helps in graphing inequalities on a number line. MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day.